All of each one of which is extremely important in and of itself. God, I offer myself to thee to build with me and to do with me as thou wilt. This is an offer. It has not yet been accepted. God will accept this offer in his time. We're saying, here I am, God, take me. But am I presently able to be taken? In most cases, no, because I'm still blocked from God by all my defects and all of my guilts and all of my insanities. Nevertheless, I've offered without reservation for God to take me into his care, to use me, to build with me, and to do with me as he wants. We have held nothing back. It was voiced, as the big book says, without reservation. At this point, we are forming a partnership with God. We are asking him for something, but we are likewise committing ourselves to do something, which is to go forward with the rest of the steps. Now, we just got through looking to see how devastating self can be. And so now we ask God, relieve me of the bondage of self, that I may better do thy will. This is our first acknowledgement in the big book. That the reason that we are here. The reason we're here is not so that we can be healthy, wealthy, and wise and have a house on the bay and a 50-foot Matthews. Why we're here is to better do God's will. We are to take up the work that he ascribes to us. We're to carry his message. We are to be of maximum benefit to God and our fellows. That's why we're here. And when we're tied up in self, we cannot follow his will. Take away my difficulties. Well, we don't know what those are yet because we haven't done inventory, but we know that there's something dreadfully wrong. These difficulties the third step prayer talks about are our insanities, our defects of character, and our guilts. Take away my difficulties, that victory over them may bear witness to those I would help. Of thy power, thy love, and thy way of life. You see what's happened here? We're asking God to make examples of us so that we can be helpful to others, not of how great we are, but of how great he is. And then finally, may I do thy will always. This is the first time we've seen this. We're going to find that repeated over and over again. Something that we do as we go through each day. Thy will, not mine, be done, God. What do you want me to do next, God? Please give me the power to carry it out. So you see that by this time, this great gift has been given and the decision has been made, and through our actions, we have done those things necessary to implement that decision. So now we have the first, second, and third steps, and they've carried us this far. Now we know that there are so many things about us that need to be fixed, that need to be removed, that need to be changed. Knowing that we're blocked from God at this point, what do we do next? You see, it's led us directly up to the fourth step, hasn't it? We're going to take a moral inventory, searching, honest inventory. We're going to look at our past and we're going to find out what it is that's wrong with us. What does the fourth step say? Made a searching and fearless moral inventory of ourselves. Now some people will say, oh, don't be in any hurry to work that. What's the big book say? Let's look at the top of page 64. It's pretty clear here, I think. Now, talking about the third step, though our decision, that's the third step decision, was a vital and crucial step, it could have little permanent effect unless... What is this? At once? Holy cow, at once? Followed by a strenuous effort to face and to be rid of the things in ourselves which have been blocking us? Why do we have to do that? Well, our liquor was but a symptom, so we had to get down to causes and conditions, didn't we? At once. The third step prayer, boom, fourth step. Now, the fourth step, let it be known, is not an autobiography. It is not the answer to 697 questions, which I happened to see the other day. I shared this with you. One of those questions was, Have you ever been caught masturbating? Can you imagine? Can you imagine?
Only two people saw that.
You saw that too, didn't you? Yeah. It's, and I looked at that list of questions, 697 questions. I was talking to the guy who's been trying to work his four step with these questions. I said, how long have you been working on this? He said, well, let's see, it's been about 4.5 months now. How far are you? I haven't gotten to the 300th question yet. I said, what have you learned? He said, nothing. I said, do you want to work a four step? He said, yeah. I said, you want some help? He said, yeah. I said, okay, I'll show you what to do. I got a call the next day from his sponsor. What are you doing? You're stepping all over my sponsee. And I said, calm down, it's okay. Why don't you talk to him, see what he wants to do? But you ought to be bloody ashamed of yourself, son. Look what you're doing to him. Where in the world? Let me ask you a question I asked him. Where is this in the big book? Where do you find any of this in the big book? Well, I don't work for the big book. Oh. The big book is outmoded. It was written by a bunch of old guys back there in the 30s. Mostly waspy guys. They're too old and it's all outmoded. And now we have modern stuff. Remember what it says on page 164? We have learned that we know but little, and more will be revealed to you and to us. And this has all been revealed to we who are modern. Some words like that. It wasn't quite that good. Anyway, I think his sponsee is probably going to work the four step the way it's set out in the big book. Here's the point, of course. The four step, first of all, we have to understand what it is. Four step is not an autobiography. It is a search for the truth about ourselves. It is not designed to indict us or to make us wrong or bad. It is to find out what it is that's happened and where we are today. What is it about ourselves that blocks us from God that we cannot change ourselves? Now you can forget all about seven deadly sins. We don't deal with sin here. Besides, those sins haven't anything to do with defects. They have to do with sinful action. And we're not talking about that here. We're talking about defects of character. In order to find out what blocks us from God, we have to find out what our defects are and what our insanities are and what our guilts are, and those are the things which block us from God. And we have to do it right away. So as we look at the fourth step, we find that it is inspirationally designed to accomplish exactly that. And it will point out in widescreen Technicolor stereophonic and Dolby sound precisely what it is that's wrong with us. It's going to illuminate those twists of character, those deep dark things about us which we have been denying and running from all of these years. And in principle, it is going to show us the four cardinal defects. That's my term, because I don't know what else to call them. Dishonesty, selfishness, resentment, and fear. If you look carefully at the directions for the four step in the big book, you will find that these are the four defects which are iterated and reiterated. And then when you look at the tenth step, you will find that again in the tenth step, these same four defects are iterated and reiterated. And then in the 11th step, again, the same four defects. Dishonesty, selfishness, resentment, and fear. And therefore, it is easy for us by reading the complete big book and looking at all the steps to recognize that these four defects of character are the ones which are clearly illuminated and dug out by us working our four step. And that we therefore learn how to find them, and in our 10th step we can find them on a daily basis as they crop up, and in our 11th step each night we get a chance to review the day and see what's happened in light of those defects. These are the defects which will kill us. These are the defects which block us from God. And each and every one of them is fear-driven. For example, we are not angry or resentful unless we are threatened by somebody or something. When we do our resentment list, we find fear lies behind every anger, every resentment. We're not dishonest unless we're afraid of the results of being honest. We're not selfish or self-centered unless we're afraid that if we do not direct our own lives that we won't get what we want and what we think we need, that life will be a shambles. Especially we're not going to get enough of entertainment and sex.